Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to use an if statement in Microsoft Power Query. So here's our data set in Microsoft Excel. And the first option we're going to show you in Power Query is how to use a conditional column. And the second option we are going to show you is how to use a custom column. And in both cases, the product category is either going to be ranked as slow selling or fast selling. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So for my first method, using a conditional column, I'm going to highlight my data set, and then I'm going to go over here to the Data tab. And in this first group, I'm going to click From Table Range. And when I'm prompted to create a table right here, I'm going to say OK, and make sure that this box is checked that says My Table Has Headers. And when I do that, the Power Query window is going to appear. So once I'm in Power Query, I'm going to go up here and click Add Column. And then I'm going to click this option here for Conditional Column. And now I'm able to type in a condition. So if I move this aside for a second and I look at my data, what I would like to do is I would like to have a fourth column over here, and I want that to be called Product Category. So right here for my column name, I'm going to type in Product Category. And so for this category, what I would like to do is take my quantity sold, and anything that's sold over 50, I'm going to call fast selling. And anything that is less than or equal to 50, I'm going to call slow selling. So under column name, I'm going to pick quantity sold. And my operator right here, I'm going to pick is greater than. And the value is going to be 50. And if I move my window just a little bit over, the next box over here is what do I want my column to say if this condition is true? So if quantity sold is greater than 50, then remember I want to call this fast selling. And then if I go down here to my else statement and click in here, I'm going to call this slow selling. And then I'm going to click OK. And then I'm going to go up here to home and go close and load. And I can see that a new table has been created. Here is my initial data, and here is my conditional column. And I can see that this one is 50, so it's marked slow. This is 120, so it's fast. This is 30, so it's slow. So this column is telling me what I wanted to know about the speed of the sales of each one of my products. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So now if I go back to the Data tab, I'm going to show you a second method called using a custom column. So I already created a table here with my initial data set, but I want to show you how to do that again. So say I've formatted this as a table and I no longer want that table. I can go onto the table design ribbon up here, which automatically appears whenever I select my table. And then I can click the button right here that says convert to range. And it's going to ask if I want to convert the table to a normal range, and I'm just going to say yes. And this is going to set my data back to looking like a regular spreadsheet instead of an Excel table. And I just did that so you understood how to go from creating a table to uncreating a table to recreating a table. So if I highlight my data again, and I go back to the data ribbon, and I click on from table range, it's going to ask me again, where's my data for my table? And I'm just going to leave what I had selected and say, okay. And then I will be brought again to Power Query. And this time I'm going to go to add column. And instead of a conditional column, I'm going to go over here to custom column. And over here for my new column name, I'm just going to say product category. And then I can go down here and I can start typing my formula. So in this case, I'm going to type if, and then I'm going to look at my available columns over here. So the column I would like to use is quantity sold. So I'm going to highlight that one and click insert. So if quantity sold is greater than 50, then I'm going to type the word then. And what would I like to return if it's greater than 50? Well, in double quotes, I'm going to write fast selling. And then I'm going to type the word else. And then I'm going to type slow selling, with both fast selling and slow selling in double quotes. And then I can see that no syntax errors have been detected. So then I'm going to click OK. And I can see this new column over here. If I see 50, it is slow selling, 120 is fast selling, just like before. So if I go back to home and I click close and load, I can see that a new tab was added. And I can see that I have this custom column right here for my product category. And while it's doing the same thing as my conditional column that I added, what I wanted to say is that this is a good example to show you how you can use both a conditional column and a custom column. But you can hopefully see by now that you would want to use a custom column when you have some kind of criteria to evaluate that might be a little bit more complicated than just a standard conditional if statement. So hopefully that gives you a couple of ideas of how you can use an if statement in Power Query. If you would like further explanation on this topic, I'm going to include the link to our blog below in the YouTube description. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.